讲这场比赛。
Coach, talk about this game.
Man, we ran into a Mack truck named DEA today. You know, law of average caught up to us today after two highly emotional games and our playing just to get to where we are. And, you know, I'll give credit to how DEA was highly prepared for us. They definitely able to maximize that time off and really did a great job of scouting us and shut down a lot of the primary options we usually look for. We definitely didn't help our situation by shooting a terrible 3-point percentage. I mean, you shoot 6 for 39 against DEA, it's not gonna be gonna be a long night. And at this point of the season, you know, teams that can take care of the ball and adjust to the intensity of the defensive pressure usually comes out on top. DEA was able to force 20 turnovers on our end, and they converted 25 though, off of those turnovers, while usually we're the ones forcing teams into turnovers, and we only were able to force them to 15. So that's something that we'll look at on the video and see how we can fix that issue. First half, we had major issues in a rebounding category. They had us by double, especially on the offensive rebound. So those house hustle stats really showed out in regards to the outcome of this game and the large margin of victory on against us. So back to the drawing board. Obviously, you know, it's a great thing that in a series you don't win or advance through one game. So whether we lost by one or in this case lost by 38, 48. So a loss is a loss, and we'll mark it as that.
教练说，就是中信今天就是在他们准备非常非常好，然后把我们一些主要的一些进攻的武器都有守下来。那我们自己的话，则是从两场非常情绪化的一个比赛里面走出来。那大家的那个状况可能稍微调整的时候，可能有点因为比赛结束之后太开心，然后太过情绪化，然后现在有点回到一点比较低潮一个状况。那这个状况在我们今天投篮命中率很明显的表现出来。那说不管怎么样，39投6中，然后命中率只有15%的时候，不管对上谁要赢球都非常非常困难。然后再来就是中信今天对我们做的非常好，是篮板，上半场篮板我们输了快20了。然后再来就是他们制造我们20个失误，然后从失误里面得了25分。那通常这个数据通常是相反，通常是我们制造对方失误比较多，然后从失误里面做得分。那等于是，所以今天中信做的都非常非常好。那但是教练也特别提到的说，他说这个季后赛不是一场定生死，而是打三场比赛，看谁先赢到第三场比赛，然后分胜负这样。那今天不管是输一分，或像今天说48分，对我们来说都只输一场比赛。那我们就接下来回去好好再做修正这样。
好，谢谢。接下来我们请丁丁来谈一下球队的状况，还有自己的表现。
球队状况，我觉得我们进攻端虽然说投不进，可能就是因为像教练刚刚讲的，我们刚从很激烈的playing， 然后打完之后然后过来，所以球队的团命中率方面表现不是很好。但我觉得主要今天问题比较大的是进攻的防守方面，我们让他们拿了126分，我不觉得这是一个季后赛球队应该要有的得分，我们应该想办法把他们压在100分以下，这样我们才有机会进球这样。那他们最后也拿到42个助攻、55个篮板，然后命中率基本上都在50以上。那我觉得这是我们必须要马上去修正。那进攻方面，我觉得每个人打球的人都是有命中率，然后我们前两场命中率很高，然后这场修正回来，那我觉得是还好，只要我们有勇气继续投下去，我觉得进攻方面都还好。所以是防守方面是我们必须马上去修正。对，
好，接下来开放现场媒体发问。
担心输这么多分，对下一场士气可能会有影响。
我觉得不会啊，因为其实我们去年也是有这样子打过季后赛，虽然说去年好像不记得有出过这么多分，但我觉得其实一场球赛，因为我们是打一个系列赛，不是打一场，那我觉得不管输一百分、输一分都是输，那我觉得不管输几分，我们就是要准备好自己，因为像我们今天，我不觉得我们今天有准备好自己去打这场比赛，那我觉得我们现在两天休息日就是想办法武装自己去打下一场。
杜哥，
那问一下教练，就是莱斯挑战在两场是拿了合计拿了90分。
对。
那今天很明显被对手封住，那有没有什么方式希望替他解答？或者教练今天看到他在进攻端有什么样的问题，就是马上需要补正
的？Rating average of 45 points in the last two games he played, and today he scored 13 points. And do you see any just
Obviously, DA's defensive scheme was to try to get the ball out of Ray's hands. So it's be my job to find ways to where they won't be able to maximize two guys on him. So that's going to be a major adjustment on our end as a coaching staff and find opportunities where. They won't be able to execute that trapping defense if there's on our primary score. Obviously, you know, Ray's efforts in the play-in was Herculean. One game he played over 50 minutes, and then our last game, you know, with that game-winning shot, these guys aren't robots, The human side of him kicked in today, but knowing the competitive fire and the competitive warrior Ray is, he'll be back, he'll be ready, and we'll figure things out on Thursday.
教练就是说，今天的中心的策略就是尽量不要让 Ray 有太轻松接到球，或即便接到球有轻松进攻篮筐的机会。那他说中心做得非常好，然后说接下来就是我们自己教练的任务，要怎么样去修正。这个状况让，比如说在中心在两个人做包夹的时候，让他们多，让我们其他进攻点可以打得更开这样子。然后说，瑞虽然在上一轮打得非常非常好，但他也不是机器人。然后他说，每个人都一定会高潮跟低潮。他说今天就是一个对瑞一个比较低潮的一个状况。那但是他也不担心，因为瑞是一个非常有竞争力、非常有竞争性的一个球员，他一定会再反弹这样子。
好，现场还有媒体想要发问的吗？好，没有的话，那我们记者会到这边结束，谢谢。